Welcome back to this next tutorial in the personalization series. In the previous tutorials, we've set up the customer journey and personas, and we've scored the content and the referrals based on the customer journey and the personas. To give you a better feeling of how the algorithm works, we're gonna look into a really cool feature of the U-Marketing suite called the cockpit. If you go back to your website, you see this page. We've scored this page. It's this page in the content tree. We've scored it. It's typically a page for a coffee drinker who is in the think or in the do phase. The algorithm is now, or the U-Marketing suite is now scoring points for this page. But to get a feeling of how it works, we gonna add a snippet of code to your website, and it will help you understand the U-Marketing suite. This is Visual Studio. This is my master template. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna insert one partial that you get with the U-Marketing suite. It's located in the folder Views, Partials, U-Marketing Suite, Cockpit. And to add that, you should write HTML.partial U-Marketing Suite / cockpit. And that will render this view. We're gonna save that. And we're gonna reload this page. And once the page is reloaded, you will see the U-Marketing Suite logo and an open button. It's important to notice that this thing is only rendered if you are logged into Embraco. So your average website user won't see the cockpit, but if you're logged into Embraco, you will see this. You can click on open, and there it is. You can decide to put it on the left, or you can align it to the right, whatever you want. And we have a few sections within it. In the analytics section, we have client-side data that's reported. For example, the time on page, but also the engage time on page. It's important to notice there's a difference between the engage time on page and the time on page, because at this moment I'm on the page, but I'm doing nothing particular on this website. So for example, maybe I would go to the coffee machine and grab myself a cup of coffee. I'm still on the page, but I'm not actively working on the page. Only if I move my mouse or if I click, the engage time on page is running, and then also for another 5 seconds. Or if I scroll, for example, it will also start counting. It's also storing the scroll depth on the page, or the maximum scroll depth, events or outclicks. For example, this moment I clicked out to joesdcompany.com. This is all kinds of data that is stored in the U-Marketing suite and which the cockpit visualizes. Also, we have some data reporting, like which browser am I using, which kind of device, how many pages did I visit in this session, how many sessions did I have, etc. For this demo, I'm going to delete my cookie, so I have deleted all my previous visits. Now I will get assigned a new cookie, and the U-Marketing suite thinks I'm a new visitor. If I go back to the top menu and I go to personalization, I will see the personas that I've set up and the customer journey that I've set up. At this moment, we don't have any scores or any points. But if I go to this website, for example, to this this page, and remember, we've scored the customer journey and the personas for this page, I'm going to this website, you will see I get points. I get points for this persona and points for this customer journey step. I will switch it over to the right side for a moment. And if I go to the next page, for example, about coffee, I will get more points and more and different journey steps. That's because I've scored about coffee as well on different phases. I can also go to the FHQ, where I've scored even more different customer journey steps. So if I go to FHQ, you will see I get points. I've browsed through different web pages and I've came up with this scorecard. The cockpit really helps you visualizing the points that are assigned to the different pages, and in that way you can test whether you've assigned the points correctly. It's important to notice that per customer journey group and persona group, there can only be one active persona or customer journey. In this case, it's the coffee drinker that's active and the journey phase think. If you have set up multiple persona groups or multiple customer journeys, you can have multiple journey steps active, but only one per group. In this video, I've shown you a quick overview of the cockpit and how that works. It really helps you to understand what the U-Marketing Suite is measuring and how we can use that in a later video to segmentize the visitors and personalize your website. See you in the next video.